Hey, this is Max. Thanks for taking an interest in the Smith River. The Smith River is an inviting place for fishermen and paddlers alike to spend a day enjoying our area's natural beauty. But the river is always changing, and it's important to follow a few guidelines to keep you safe during your outdoor adventure. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers operates Philpott Dam to generate power for surrounding communities. This is where the Smith River gets started in the Henry County area. This is what the dam looks like during power generation. It's always best to paddle with a buddy, but if that's not possible, call someone and let them know where you will be and when to expect you back. If you're planning a day on the river, always remember to call ahead and get the power generation schedule for the day. Make a note of when the power generation is scheduled to start, and keep an eye on your watch. Remember that fishermen are especially vulnerable to rising water levels, so when it's time for power generation to start, don't waste any time in getting out. The water release schedule may change without notice. It's a good idea to pick a reference point, such as a large rock, and keep an eye on the water level. If it starts to rise, it's best to get out of the river and come back on another day. To illustrate paddling safety, let's take a look at a tale of two paddlers. Jennifer is a safe, experienced paddler. Notice that she's wearing water-resistant clothing that will dry out quickly if it becomes wet. She brought her first aid kit. She also packed a throw rope. It's always a good idea to have one in case a paddler falls in the water. And of course, you should always wear your life jacket. Jen is also wearing a spray skirt to protect the kayak from getting filled with water. She enters the kayak while it's just offshore. She fastens the spray skirt and she's ready to go. And here comes Paddler Bob. He's pretty much the image of everything not to do on the river. He's wearing clothes that won't dry out very quickly. During power generation, the water in the river can be as cold as 45 degrees. Instead of bringing water that will keep him hydrated, Paddler Bob has brought along some alcohol to take on the river. It looks like Jen is asking Paddler Bob what he's going to do with his life jacket. Paddler Bob says it's okay. He's got his life jacket right next to him. Watch as Paddler Bob enters the canoe in completely the wrong way. When entering a canoe or kayak, always remember to use 3 points of contact to keep the vessel steady as you enter. Downstream, Paddler Bob fishes just offshore. It looks like Jennifer is about to let him know that even if you're fishing just offshore, you should still have your life jacket on. After some more drinking, it looks like Paddler Bob is ready to head a little further downstream, but he throws his trash into the river. Litter such as this is harmful to wildlife and can even pose a hazard for other paddlers. Uh-oh, Paddler Bob is in a world of trouble now. He didn't call ahead to see if the river would fit for his paddling abilities, and now he's got to negotiate the rapids. What's worse is that he's not wearing his life jacket. It's not going to do him any good sitting next to him in the canoe if he falls into the river. Downstream, Jennifer has already left the river and is taking a break when she starts to notice something. There's a trail of familiar-looking debris. What's this beer can doing in the river? And she's seen this cooler before. These kind of look like Paddler Bob's things. And here's that life jacket that he didn't want to put on. I wonder what else will come floating down the river. Oh no, here comes Paddler Bob's paddle and his hat. I sure hope Paddler Bob is okay. She can hear a familiar voice shouting for help. She looks upstream to see who's in trouble. The whistle will alert any nearby boaters that someone is in trouble. And there's Paddler Bob trying to get back to shore. It's a good thing Jen brought her throw rope. Paddler Bob is out of the water, but he's not out of the woods. Even on a hot August day, hypothermia is a real possibility due to the cold water at times of power generation. Luckily, Jennifer had a safety blanket in her first aid kit. Paddler Bob learned from his mistakes, and now he's got all the proper gear. He's actually wearing his life jacket this time, and he's got a spare paddle in case he loses his first one. He's dressed appropriately for the cold water, and this time it looks like he's brought along a throw rope, and he's got a first aid kit as well. Paddler Bob is almost ready to go, but he forgot one thing. It's important to bring water instead of beer. Drinking alcohol can impair your judgment on the river. If you follow these simple safety tips, you can have a great time on the river and come back to paddle on another day. Thanks for watching.